day two.
I would like to share a few things. Hello guys and girls agents, it's me Sasha with my broken English and daily The Division videos. So what's happened on day 2? Well, I know it's already day 3 actually from day this video is released and people are already level 30. But let me share a few things with you people. So far I've upgraded my security wings in the base with shooting range, where you can try out some of the weapons you didn't yet, like this SRS sniper rifle. Which one you can try out everywhere outside of the base. Shame, I thought this should be free and no effort to access it as it's a part of a training in our games. Well, you may also would like to upgrade your tech wings with recharge center upgrade to increase Dark Zone Fund rewards. Okay, so I also figured out what is repurposed modifications. Unfortunately, I didn't find many items to support this mod in my inventory. Only this officer bag supported any modification, so I decided to put this mod there. Why this? I don't know why. Cause I like it. Trying to make some balance between firearms, stamina and electronic. Next thing that I would like to share with you guys and girls is the locations of a few crashed drones I found. So, because it's a bit hard for me to pronounce the name of the streets and etc, just pause the video and see for yourself the exact location. A funny thing is how you can empty a whole white machine gun magazine in a single elite cleaner. As well, watch out when you double press your deploy key to deploy the turret, as it might be deployed on a very bad spot. There we go, a tip! At this extraction point near the Dark Zone 1 entry, once you fire a flare to call a helicopter for extraction, a bit later near the time for extractions, an NPCs are always appear, so it's a simple way for farming. By the way, if you see an NPC with a flashlight, keep your heads down, it's a sniper. Just wait till you make a shot and take your time to fire back. Well, on a gameplay, if you get out of ammo, try to switch to another weapon if you have extra one in your inventory, even lower level, or simply play only for headshot. Or even go for a melee when you see the NPCs are low on health. As much more you level up, as more harder the missions become, and more time spent on reviving even respawn. And all missions level requirements become more higher. Here I would like to create some players which I've been matched in a matchmaking to complete the missions. Thanks for playing, people. Okay people, I hope you enjoy. I will leave you in the rest of the video with some mission gameplay. Thanks for watching.